Okay, so what we're going to do in this tutorial is look at the nose and isolate the nose from the face and draw that as a feature in and of itself, looking very careful at that. Noses come in so many different varieties and shapes, and the interesting thing about them is that there's probably no other feature on the face that will appear so differently when it's lit differently or when you're looking from a different aspect. So we're going to start out with a very simple approach, just a couple of quick lines like a triangle. By the way, I'm not using the photograph we just looked at. This is a different nose, and I'll be using an HB pencil. And one of the first things we're going to do is establish the planes of the nose. Let's start very simple in this effort. Keep it really simple, but then once we get those, and we're looking at three things here. We're looking at the size, the shape, and the location. When we feel like we've got those correct, then we can move on and maybe embellish these planes a little bit more, break them down a little bit more thoroughly so that we understand the three-dimensional structure of the nose. We can start shading in some of those planes so that we help ourselves understand where the light should be hitting, where the shadows are. And when we feel good and comfortable that what we have is solid and dimensional and is really, you know, convincing as to its dimensionality, then we can, you'll probably want to erase some of those lines that we used in the planes. They'll make it pretty busy. Erase those and start to render it. As we render it, we're looking to round and soften some of the edges and make it look more like a nose. And as we work on this part, we'll notice that the underlying structure of the top of the nose, or the top of the bridge, is actually bone, the part that we could see on a skull. But then the lower part of the nose is created, the underlying structure there is cartilage. And oftentimes in the nose, those two different sections kind of have their own separate mass. You can see a division there between those. So we will go ahead and render and shade out this. We can get highlights either by using a light pencil on the tone paper like I have done, or just erasing back in. By this time, I've moved to a softer pencil. But again, we're looking for dimensionality. Also realize that the light will play off the nose just like it does anything else. You'll have your midtones, your highlights. You'll have some core shadows, like along the ridge of the nose up there, as well as reflected light, like you're seeing at the bottom down by the nostril and whatnot. So good luck with this. I hope you enjoy it, and have fun drawing.